Gospel Focus, and I am here at the First Baptist Church of Highland Park with the legendary Richard Smallwood. We are celebrating his 75th birthday, and so many of the artists from the DMV have come out to celebrate you. You've got to be feeling quite overwhelmed.
This has been wonderful. I can't even put it into words. Just the love that everybody has showered upon me, and I forgot to mention my dear friend Twinkie Clark. I mean, she came here all the way from Detroit to honor me. And then, of course, the DMV, who I love so much. They've been so supportive all down through the years. First time we went overseas, I think I was 23. It was Celestials. And they had this great big article in the Post here about us. And we were all like 22, 23, 24. So I just said that to say that the DMV has always been so amazingly supportive, and I'm so appreciative.
Right, and to see so many of the artists who actually honor you, I had a chance to interview a couple of them while the event was going on,
okay. And
all of them said basically the exact same thing, that you've had an opportunity to mentor them, and a lot of what they do is because of you. When you hear the generation under you talking about such legacy as yourself, how does that make you feel?
It's such an honor. I mean, when I see people like Brother Damien, who played It Is Well from my Persuaded record, major musician who went to Howard University as well, and all these musicians and keyboardists, some of them I've known since they was, like they used to say, knee-high to a duck. But, you know, I'm just so proud to hear the singers singing the songs. Some of those songs I almost forgot because I've been around here a couple of years. So, but it's a blessing. It was so inspiring and so encouraging. I can't even describe how encouraging it was. Yeah.
And what I notice is that you have such a unique sound, your style, and many try to imitate that. Okay. How does that make you feel?
It makes you feel wonderful. I mean, the thing is like when I first started out, a lot of powers that be in the record industry said I couldn't write because nobody would never understand it. What was that classical stuff in there? Well, I said, well, this is what God has given me. This is, you know, when he chose me before I was in the womb, this is what he ordained that I should do. And it took a while for folks to catch on, because I got a lot of comments from folks who said, well, that's not commercial. But listen,
that is so hard to believe.
But the thing is, what you do is do what God has called you to do. Mm-hmm. If you do that and he's ordained it, I don't care what nobody say,
yes,
it's going to be successful because he is God.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I know you're 75, but 75 is really the new 55, for real. So
okay.
Can we expect something coming from Richard Smallwood in the future?
We shall see. We just sort of praying. I haven't been doing a couple. I haven't been doing anything really for the past couple of years because I've had some challenges. I had a couple of operations on my leg, my knee, so I'm just sort of getting back to what I do. I will never stop. I love it. It's what I do, but we're taking it slowly.
I wish I had like hours with you just to sit and talk, because I'm sure you have stories down through the years, but it's been a long night. I will ask you one question, though, because you had a chance to come up your mentor. Tell us about your mentor those days at Howard University.
Oh, wow. Howard was one of the most amazing things that has happened to me. I came to Howard as a freshman. I was 18 years old. Graduated from McKinley High School, and the wonderful, legendary late Miss Beatrice Gilks was the music teacher there. And she went up to Howard when I was a senior, mm-hmm, and went to Dean Lawson, who was the dean of the School of Music, and said, "This is one of my students, and he needs a scholarship." I didn't have to pay one dime. I didn't have to buy books.
Awesome. So
God just really opened the doors. I mean, I had so many mentors at Howard. One was Donnie Hathaway, who I went to school with. One was my piano teacher, Dr. Thomas Kerr, who told me, you could play gospel any kind of way you want to. If you want to use some classical in it, you can do that. And he was the one that encouraged me to sort of mix the classical thing and stuff like that. And of course, she wasn't at Howard, but my mama, she was the one. She was the one. She started exposing me to music when I was about 5 years, 4 years old. And she started buying records and stuff. And she would take me then. It was the Roberta Martin singers and the Davis sisters and the Ward singers. I was listening to those people when I was 5 and 6 years old. So that's who I sort of cut my teeth on, and the people that I emulated. So I think, you know, the memory of my great mother who just instilled in me that you can do whatever you want to do. All you got to do is put God first, and all things are possible.
That's awesome. Yeah. And that's a great way to wrap it up. This has been awesome. Thank you so much, and happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. This has been wonderful. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. The legendary Richard Smallwood on Gospel Focus.